What's good, y'all? So this will be my little tutorial or whatever about dyeing your hair. So I've been dyeing my hair since I was in sixth grade, so this is nothing new to me, but this is just like what I do and how I get it, like the color that I want it. Because usually, like, when I dye it, I use like the actual like stuff. When I dye it, I don't use box dye, I don't use none else. I use like the developer and the color to get the color I want. Like, I don't use box dye unless I'm dyeing it black, because box dye, you never get what you want. But if you do it like the professional way, you can like control it better. So that's what I do. So basically, I went from blonde to this like burgundy brownish thing, whatever. I like it. It's decent. It's something to hold me over until I go black again, because I was getting really tired of the blonde. It was turning orange. I didn't feel like looking for a toner that was gonna keep it blonde. And then plus it's about to be fall anyways, and like I think a color like this is good for the fall. So this is gonna be me showing y'all exactly how I did that, how I got that color, and then like things I do like after to like style it and keep it like this. It's really small. Usually my hair would be like bigger, but because I dyed it and plus I put gel on it after, it was very like it's very like play down. Like I could make it bigger, but I don't really feel like picking it up. But yeah, so just keep on watching and y'all can see exactly what I did to get this color. So to get this color, I used really four things. So I used this Clairol developer. It's been through some stuff, but this is the 30 volume one. We have the color Brilliant Ion color. This is in light burgundy brown. So in a little mixing bowl like this, you can use a regular bowl, but it's better if you have like something that is like you can reuse. So I have this and this little mixing tool and then the brush itself. So yeah, and that's really all you need to get everything together and get started. So we're just gonna go into it right now. Color together in a little mixing bowl like this. You can use a regular bowl, but it's better if you have like something that is like you can reuse. So I have this and this is a mixing tool and then the brush itself. So yeah, and that's really all you need to get everything together and get started. So we're just gonna go into it right now. So basically, y'all can see I look like a fucking chicken, but my hair is like orange, so I'm just taking the red dye and then I'm just brushing it down my hair. Not too special. I'm not using gloves either, but I never use gloves when I dye my hair just because I just don't feel like I need them. So I'm just, you know, painting it, kind of getting it like everywhere I see, everywhere I think needs it. And yeah, just rubbing it down. Sorry, y'all, I'm sick, that's why I sound crazy, but just rubbing it in like that and making sure I get literally everywhere, because if I don't, it's gonna be fucked up and I'm gonna have uneven patches of color. So I'm just rubbing it in like that, and then I'm making sure to get the other side too. I'm just rubbing it, and I'm gonna speed the video up so y'all don't gotta watch the whole thing. Okay, so I finished that part and I still got this fat ass blonde puff in the back of my head. So I'm gonna just go ahead and take it out. Clearly it hurt. And take it out in the little ponytail. You can see the difference of the dye already taking place. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do the exact same thing that I did before. But I didn't have as much dye, so I was just starting putting it on the end. So that would go ahead and tape. And now I'm just rubbing it in just like I was doing the last one, and now I'm splitting it in half so I can just go ahead and make that work. So you can see I'm putting more developer into the bowl, so even though the color won't be as maybe not as intense, I guess could be the word, it'll still be there. And I'm just taking what little left of the actual liquid color I have, and I'm putting it into the bowl with the developer, so it can kind of even out, not really, but it at least helps, and helps there'll be more color in the mixture. So I'm just gonna put up the part of my head I already have dyed and continue to do the same thing that I was doing before. Gonna take a shower cap and I'm just gonna put it on top of my head, try to get as much hair as I can in, and I'm just gonna put it in for about 10 minutes so that the color can heat up and take a little bit better to my head. And this helps a lot. I recommend you do it. So now I have just washed my hair freshly. You can see the color took. And now all I'm going to do is I'm going to start t-shirt drying it. You should never dry your hair with a towel. Now I'm going to take this product, the Equal Styler, put it through my hair, and do some finger twists.
Basically it for my hair. After the finger twist, I just let it dry. I have a fan on my room, so I just ran my fan so my hair could dry faster. And that was basically all I did, and then dry like this, because I don't use no like blow dryers or diffusers or nothing. Unless I really need to, I would just let it air dry. And this right here is how it came out the next morning. So thank y'all for watching. Make sure you subscribe if you into that kind of shit, and you know, leave some comments down below, like the video, all that other bullshit YouTubers be saying. But yeah, that's it. That's all I have for y'all. So thanks for watching. Bye.